you may be running, you're trying to get from A to B. And your head's all thumping and your heart's all a pumping and you feel anxiety. Just take the throw to the telly show, what's your answer, you see?
Showering once a month. Up to my right, we have Dr. Todd. Yes, folks, he's a real doctor. Not sure if he's a real Todd. On the back on the drums, making all my jokes sound funnier, we have Scott Winberg. And back there on the bass, we have James Key.
Eso es el hijo de Raúl y Debbie. Miguelito de la Torre.
All right, you guys enjoying all the junk food here at Knott's? You got some, who's got some chicken today? Yeah, how about some boysenberry pie? We like pie so much, we wrote a song about it. Here we go.
We're telling you a month club here to tell you why. Everybody needs to learn about pie. The apple, cherry, boysenberry, chocolate, or meringue. But a never ending number that rules. A constant that constantly will blow your mind. A ratio of irrational kind, circumference divided by diameter, and pi is what you get. 3.14159265358979392.
Like to hear it, here goes.
Well, Mr. Old Frog, sitting on the lily pad, singing a song. He's been hopping along. Well, he loves to sing and strum those guitars every evening in this swampy mall, all alone, always. And for a while, he was on his own, yeah. Then, one day, next to the firefly, he heard the horn and shouts out loud.
Hey there, frog, I'm a banjo player. Let's make this a duo. What do you say? There's nothing like a brand new friend.
Sing and play those guitars every evening in this swampy marsh. And then one day, Mr. Bullfrog said,
friendship. In the beginning of it, we started a lemonade stand. It was pretty successful.
Sugar, lemons, ice, a table, and a sack. Comes from Mikey's lemonade in
Cause two heads are better than one. Thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. Now, by a show of hands, who knows how to tie their shoes? Put your hand down, Crum.
This one's called Charlie the Pollywog.
Well, Charlie was a pollywog from Tippecanoe. He was a sad poor boy, let me tell you. He never, ever, ever learned to tie his shoes. He just sang in the blues and played the kazoo. Charlie saw his good friend Gil. He was an all-without catfish from Capitol Hill. Gil said,
Charlie, I can show you how to tie your shoes.
But catfish Gil didn't have a clue. Gil said,
first take your laces and pull them tight, then stick them right in your ear.
Your rear.
Your ear.
Then the boys heard a sudden noise and a brand new friend appeared. Oh, how was the hell of it that happened to you? The tadpole with the shoelaces is here. I said,
hey there, Gil, you're doing it all wrong. Step aside, listen up, try to follow along. Take that shoe, put it on your head, and wrap the string under your chin. When you tie up your laces before every race, then you're sure to win.
Well, Charlie was a pollywog from Tippecanoe. He was a tadpole boy. Shoes, he just sang in the blues and played a kazoo. Yeah. Well, these three boys are all tied up and they're not sure what to do. Sure hope someone comes along and shows them how to tie their and how to handle it too. Well, these three friends finally agreed that they didn't have to worry.
No, we did not have to worry.
No, we didn't have to worry.
Cause they didn't have feet. Saturday. chopping log. Who's that fella with the red hot chair, big fat mustache, and he's singing a cappella? He's the one that's the butcher.
All right, Boris, nicely done. You got anything else for us? Waffles, all right. We love waffles, and so does our good buddy Ben Parks. This one's for you, Ben. Yeah.
Charlie Brown. Let's turn that frown upside down. You know, you don't have to be the best guitar player in town. What matters is just being happy and doing something that you love. You know, like baseball or kicking a football.
Ha! That'll be the day. We'll see.
He's right, Charlie Brown. You don't have to be the best at baseball, football, checkers, or any of that stuff. As long as doing those things make you smile, just enjoy doing them and concentrate on being the best Charlie Brown that you can be. And, in my humble opinion, Charlie Brown, of all the Charlie Browns in the world, you're the Charlie Browniest.
Aww.
I'm all right.